Numeric literals can be further divided into integer literal, float literal, and the third one is complex. Okay, these are the three different classification of numeric literals. Numeric first classification is the integer. Okay, whole numbers, either positive or negative whole numbers are the values that are included in integer literals. Okay, for example, age equal to 12. Okay, this is an integer value. Mark equal to 125. Okay, again value equal to -225. Okay, either positive or negative values can be included. Whole numbers with negative or positive numbers can be included as integers. Okay, integer values. Okay, next one is the float. Okay, float means decimal values can be also used. Either positive or negative decimal numbers are used in the floating point. Okay, length 25.28. Okay, breadth 12.52, x -14.11. Okay, all these are floating point numbers. Okay, they will be having decimal part also. Integer part and decimal part will be there. Okay, and the third one is the complex numbers. Okay, complex numbers generally have it is a combination of two or more real numbers. Okay, complex numbers are generally a combination of two or more real numbers. Okay, real numbers are included as real numbers. Combination of real numbers are included as complex numbers. For example, 12.6j. Okay, here 6 is the imaginary part, and the imaginary part is denoted by the letter j. Okay, integer and real number and imaginary part, real part and imaginary part. Okay, okay, if we are giving x equal to 12 plus 6j. okay, this is the imaginary, this is the real part and this is the imaginary part of the complex number. So x dot real, this function is used for getting the real part of the real part of complex number. X dot image. Okay, this can be used for writing the, for getting the imaginary part of the number. Okay, so dot real and dot image. Okay, these two functions are used for getting, used in the complex numbers for getting the imaginary part as well as the real part of the number. Okay, now let's see some of the examples in Python programming. Okay, okay, the next token is the punctuators. Okay, punctuators consist of various symbols. Okay, these are the symbols such as brackets, curly bracket, round bracket, square bracket, full stop, comma, semicolon, colon. All these symbols comes under the punctuators. Okay, they are the separators. Okay, they are used for separating various values. Okay, full stop helps us to stop a particular statement. Comma helps us to separate two values. All these are separators. Okay, these punctuators are used for separating the values. Okay, and they are used in the programs. Okay, programs for separating it from others. Okay, next one is the operator. The last token is the operators. Operators are used for various mathematical calculations. Okay, operators. Okay, for doing various mathematical calculations, we use the operators. We have to study in detail about the operators. Okay, we will study it in the later sessions about the operators.